Hello friends, this video on areas of parallelogram and triangles part 1 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. The topics to be covered in this chapter are introduction, we'll understand figures on same base and same parallel, and when I say figures, I'll talk mostly about parallelogram and triangles. That means we'll study parallelogram on the same base and between same parallels and triangles on the same base and between same parallels. So what does it mean, same base and same parallel? I'll tell you shortly. And then we'll do a quick shot. It's more about understanding parallelograms and triangles, these two figures. On the same base, you see these two have the same base. The gray parallelogram and the purple parallelogram are the same base. This is the same base AB here, you see. Right? This one AB, CD, E here. So parallelogram A, B, C, D and parallelogram will be somewhere F. And the parallelogram A, B, E will have the same base AB. They have same base AB and they are between the same parallels. You see, this line AB is parallel to CD and EF is also aligned with the CD, they are between the same parallel and this is the same. Also, you see these two triangles, they are also the green triangles and the blue triangles, the base is same and they are between the same parallels. So, if you don't understand, it's okay, hold on for some time. We'll understand this in more detail. In this whole chapter, we'll be studying about parallelograms and triangles between the same base and same parallels. So, the whole chapter is about the area. What is an area? Thing, what is an area? The area, it is an amount of shape inside a boundary of a two-dimensional object. So when you talk about area, we talk mainly about two-dimensional object. When you talk about surface area, then we talk about three-dimensional object. But normal area, we talk about two-dimensional object. It is the amount of space inside the boundary of two-dimensional object. Or we can say it is the quantity that expresses the intent of a two-dimensional figure. Again, this is also a two-dimensional figure, and then we talk about amount of shape. That is area. Or I can say it is extent of the expansion of a two-dimensional figure or shape. For example, this is a two-dimensional figure. This is land, a piece of land. Right? This land is a two-dimensional space. It has length and width. It doesn't have height. Right? It's a two-dimensional figure. A mountain is a three-dimensional figure. It has length, width and height as well. So if we talk about this land, when you say area, area is the whole expansion, the whole green thing we visualize, that is area. Or let's suppose you want to get a triangle, this is a triangle and you want to get this painted. Then how will you calculate the charge? Right? So they'll charge you based on the area. They'll say okay, 100 rupees or $100 per square foot. So based on the area, they'll charge you. Right? So if the triangle is small, you have to pay less. If the triangle is big, so let's suppose you paint this triangle and this triangle. Both are triangles. But the painting cost will differ. Why? Because this triangle has a smaller area, less area, and this has a big area. Okay, so it is the amount of space inside the boundary of a two-dimensional object, that is the area. And we know very lot of formulas for area, popular areas for rectangle. If this is length and this is width, example, then this is L into B, this is the area. For square, both the sides are same, so it is L into L. For circle, if the radius is R, then the area is pi R square. Right? For this triangle, it's half into length into height. So this is length, and assuming this is the height of the triangle. So half into length into height. We have read about these kind of area of parallelogram, area of triangle, rectangle, square, and typically all these area is in the unit.
unit of either centimeter square or meter square, or sometimes big units you want, you can say in hectares and acres, but we'll not study about hectares and acres in this chapter. I mean, we'll focus more on centimeter square, meter square. Why? Because the unit is in centimeter. If you are taking this unit in centimeter, centimeter into centimeter is what? Centimeter square. So if you take the units in meter, this unit in meter and this unit in meter, the area will be meter square. Please note that you have, if you are taking unit in centimeter, all the units has to be in centimeter for a given figure. So you can't say that I'll take this part in centimeter, this part in meter. That is not possible. With that, you will end up in getting wrong answers. So always take one unit, okay, for a given question. So if it is centimeter, you take everything in centimeter. If it is meter, take all the units in meter. And that's why area is typically in centimeter square, meter square, depending on which unit you have. Therefore, concluding whatever we have told just now, area of the figure is nothing but a number. If you see, this will say that if this is 8 and this is 4, let's suppose. So 8 into 4 is 32 and both are in centimeter. So 32 centimeter square. This is the area of this particular rectangle. So area of the figure is a number, here in this case 32, with some unit, and here the unit is centimeter square. That is associated with the part enclosed by the figure. This figure enclosed this much space, right? So for this much space, we have given a number with the unit. This number with the unit is nothing but the area. I hope you got my point. Let's suppose the radius is 2 here. So pi r square will become pi into 2 square, right? That is nothing but 4 pi. And if you want, you can actually break it. You can actually calculate it further. 4 into 3.14. That's almost 12.56, and assume this is in meter, so it will become meter square. 12.56 meter square is the number given to this area. Okay, so area of the figure is the amount of space inside the boundary of a two-dimensional object. That is a theoretical concept. So from the mass perspective, it will be a number with a unit. Unit will be somewhere centimeter square, meter square, and that unit associated with the part enclosed by this figure. Okay, so that is area. Hope with this you understand what is area. Okay, this is 32 centimeter square, this is 12.56 meter square, some number. It will also have some number. So if you know the length and the height, you can actually come with a number for this particular triangle. That is area. The next question is, why should we study? Let's assume there is an old farmer and he wants to divide, he has a land. Let's suppose he has a triangle. So he is a triangular land and he wants to divide this among his three sons. So what he did was, let's suppose, how can I divide? The question is, how can I divide a triangular land into 3 points? So what he can do is, he can calculate three distance exact measurement, and let's suppose he joins these points and he's saying that now these three are the equal area. But is that the equal area? That's what we know, right? There will be three different areas. So he has to divide this piece of land into three equal parts. It is difficult for him. He needs to understand the concept of area more to divide this. If it is a rectangular piece of land, maybe he can actually divide this into three parts and he can just join this 3 points like this. And actually, all these three will be equal area. But if it is apart from rectangle, if it is, let's suppose, circle, and you want to divide into three pieces, he just can't divide like this. It may not be same area. Right? So we need to understand the concept, or to actually divide this piece of land into equal areas, you should understand the concept of area of other figures also. For example, parallelogram and triangle. So in this case, if there is a triangular figure, I want to divide it. So concept of triangle will help me to divide this piece of land into three equal areas. Also, for example, if I want to find the cost of painting of a wall, it all depends on the area. If it is a small area, then painting cost is less. Bigger area, painting cost. For example, if you want to get the whole flooring done, or your parents want to get the whole flooring done for your house, in that case also the cost of flooring will depend on the area. If the house is big, the cost is more. And if you want to buy property, you buy or sell property, typically in these days the properties are sold in the per square foot cost. And if you are going for a bigger house, let's suppose you are going for 2000 square foot house, it will cost you more. If you are going for 500 square foot house, cost you less, right? Because the cost, the business will cost you something, you know, let's suppose $100 per square feet. That is the fixed cost, right? Now, if you're going for 2000 square feet, the cost will be 2200. If you're going for 500 square feet, the cost will be 500 into 100. So, if you see, this is the area. This is the area. And this is price per area. And you multiply these two numbers, you get the total price. And there also, the concept of area comes into picture. So actually, it is an interesting topic to understand what is the area. And in this chapter, we'll be focusing more on the area of parallelogram and triangle. Before we proceed, let's understand the congruence, the relationship between the congruency and area. We have already studied congruency, two congruent figures. They are equal in shape and size, they are congruent figure. So if they are two figures and they are congruent, then they'll have equal area. For example, if there is figure A and figure B, if I say that figure A is congruent to figure B, that is the relationship. If A and B are congruent, then area of A has to be equal to. You can try this, try to draw various congruent figures, maybe various congruent triangles, square, rectangle, circle, and then you notice that these two congruent figures are same area. But the question is converse true? We have seen that in most of the theorems we have tried to see if the converse is true. And mostly we have seen the congruence is generally true, but in this case the converse is not true. So if there are two figures which have same area, then it need not be congruent. For example, let's take this rectangle 8 cm into 2 cm and let's take this square 4 cm into 4 cm and let's name this C and this D. So area of C rectangle is what? 8 into 2, that is 16. Area of square D is what? 4 into 4, that is 16 centimeter square. Both are centimeter square. You see that area of C is equal to area of D. But are they congruent? No, right? C is not congruent with D. Correct? So the point we are trying to prove here is if two figures are congruent, they will have same area for sure. But if two figures have same area, then they need not be congruent. Please note, if two figures A and B have same area, say are congruent, for example, in this case they are congruent, then they'll have same area for sure because they'll have same length, same width. All the parameters will be same, then the actual area that will be calculated will be same. But if there are two figures which have same area, then they need not be congruent. And one case I have shown you that is the rectangle C and the square D both have two different area. Still, they are not congruent. Okay. So typically in the real world, you don't see figures like triangles, squares, or circles. Okay. So in the real world, for example, if you want to find the area of this figure, this is a cartoon of a person, of a boy. It's a boy cartoon. If you want to find the area of, I want to get it painted. I want to get this whole thing painted red. Now, since I want to get this whole this is a two-dimensional figure, right? Painted red, I want to know the area. Correct? But how will I find the area of this? It's a little weird figure. But if you see, if you notice this, you can find the area of this circle, you can find the area of this triangle, you can find the area of this square, this triangle, this also, the legs are also triangle. So if you see, I can just number this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you notice here, the area of figure here is nothing but area of 1 plus area of 2 plus area of 3 plus area of 4 plus area of 5 plus area of 6. If you find individual area of all these triangles, squares and circles, and you will actually find the area of this whole pair. Okay? This is called an area sum property. Area sum. So if you want to find the area of any complex figure, for example, if you want to find the area of this figure also, I can show you. Right? How will you find? You can actually break this. Then you will notice that there are four semicircles and one square. You can actually find the area of this. Right? Or let's suppose you have this kind of area. This kind of figure you have. The shape of this figure, you want to find the area, then actually you duplicate this. Yeah. Area of triangle, area of the semicircle, area of triangle, area of square, area of rectangle, area of triangle. So actually you see, if you add this area, you'll actually get the area of the whole figure. Right? And that's how we do it in real world, right? You can't actually find the area of this weird figure in one go, you have to break it into triangle, square, rectangle, or any figure which you or which you can easily calculate in the area, and then you can find the area and add it. That's called area sum property of any figure. Okay. Before we start the chapter, you should know something. And if you don't know actually, I'll recommend you to visit my previous videos on these topics and then play this lessons. You should know how to find the areas of different popular figures such as rectangle, square, parallelogram, triangle, etc. Also, you should know the concepts of similarity of triangles. So we have talked about the congruency of triangles, right? Please make sure that you know how to find the similarity or congruency of triangles.
Thank you. Visit our website examfear.com to watch more and more quality education videos. You can also attend free online tests that are there in our website. You can also get access to tons of free study materials, and you can also find free tutors and mentors in this website. Thanks a lot.